Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Yes, this is another dungeon video. This is, I believe, Elden Hollow 1. Not a solo, because it has my companion Mirri, who greatly admires me apparently. Yeah, we're close, like two peas in a pod. But yeah, and I also have my pets, my Clannfear and my Twilight. But let's just get into the video and see what happens, huh? Okay, so this is Elden Hollow 1. You can find this in Elden Root. So here it's Elden Root here. And it's right around here, so you'd have to go out and then around. And there you go. This is in Grotwood, which you can find here on the map. So, shall we get this show on the road? Yes, let's get this show on the road. Right.
You wandered into the wrong hollow.
Okay, so the adepts and of course the healers are the healers. So let's get these out. This one's gonna have lots of elves. Okay, and with me today is in fact just Mirri. Yes, just Mirri. My dark elf counterpart. So, here people do get stuck, hence why I'm not exactly sprinting it. I always get stuck. So, first thing for you to know is, besides those ads, sometimes you can find a chest up here. I haven't yet, but my companions have. You know, whenever I've done this with a group, they've always run up there just to see if there's a chest. Okay, next bunch of ads is right here.
By the Imperium Light, move faster. The more bones you find, the sooner we can all get out of this.
Okay. So of course we found some healers right here. Their name is literally Healer. They're all attacking Mirri right now. Get rid of this healer right here. Okay, and now there shouldn't be any more. And now there's orcs. So basically, the miners in this place that are being told to mine bones. I don't know why, but like I paid attention to the story when I did this the first time. So here you can find a note. Okay, note of Akash, which I shall read when I do that series. Right, so here is a bunch of ads. So we'll start off with this strangler.
Don't slow down now. I will not suffer the humiliation of failure.
Okay.
Not to a cannon reed.
So shall we begin just doing this one at a time? Okay, let's take out the healers as per usual. Oh, and I've just leveled up. I didn't realize that I was supposed to get healers. Am I still enlightened by any chance? I probably am as well. What you are committing right now is treason. I'm an Aldermary. Yes guys, my character's name is now Lady Lupa Aldermary. Just to prove that, you know, she is related to Queen Irene. Who is Queen Irene Aldermary. I just found it fitting, you know. Okay, so another place that a chest may spawn is here. And again, you'll find the note that is over there on this crate here. So, another strangler. Okay, and now here we've got a healer. Goddamn Twilight. A mauler. A mauler and a mauler. So again, we'll take out this, and we've also got an archer. The healer is down. Okay, so we shall slowly work on this. Again, I will have to do my little thing with Spindle Clutch for this, as there are a bunch of adds here. Okay, you know, slowly work on them. Okay. Ooh, and I say slowly work on them, didn't I? That's not gonna happen. Oh. Because they will all just stand and wait. Cheer on as please. Of course, I'm trying my hardest. There are a lot of ads right now. Someone else is going to run in now as well. Be a digger. But the Falmor are in fact just stood there going, yep, I'm going to cheer on, doesn't matter. Send in the orcs first. Okay, and now the Falmor have joined. Ooh, yeah, thanks. Right, and before I get on with the boss, we'll send it there. Haven't spawned in just yet. Continue on with orc adds. Okay, is there anything else? There's a strangler over there, but doesn't look like there's anything else of immediate knowledge. It. So let's take out the strangler while we can. Okay, so he's spawned in now. So this is the guy that the note is to, by the way, and he is one of the pledge bosses. You need to do him in order to open up this door here. But then there's also a special one over there with an ancient spriggan, which you can do as well. So we'll start off with this guy, who is a main boss, alongside, I believe, two others. I believe he's part of the pledge bosses. It's been a while since I've done that pledge. Of course, they're on Mirri. Mirri, she died once with me just running through this to see if I could actually solo it. Mirri could die. So, hence why I probably need some taunts for this. But I'm the tank and the DPS. I do like to get up close and personal, especially with this, so that they stay away from me. I've noticed that a lot of the bosses have that mechanic, where they will stun you, so you cannot do anything, and then heavy attack you off the floor. Over now. Use my ult right now. It's not very powerful, but it did take them down a little bit. Plus, I'm using my passive that allows me to roll up 3 every 30 seconds. It does help wonders. Especially when, you know, you're doing the solo stuff and you have to do a lot of roll dodging.
Well fought.
Okay. So, we shall go and do this as well. So let's take out this guard spriggan. Okay, so as you can kind of see, this one here if my dead roth wasn't in the way. So you've got, I believe, 3 spriggans and a ancient one. The ancient is a mini boss. Only a mini boss. Hit with like 300k health. Let's just say that. And of course, Mirri has made it so that things reset a lot. I remember doing Fungal Grotto the other day with Pledge, and yeah, the bosses reset a lot because she likes to stay at range and they got to her. Okay, so I've just got a companion shield that I can sell for my companions aren't going to be tanks. Not that I'm planning. So as you can see, the door is open. That occurred after you killed the guy that was in here and not the spirit. Okay. As in this guy. Okay. So. Now we can start with doing some more of these. There is a healer in here.
Circle around.
Okay. Of course, these are orcs. Mirri is also getting the experience. There is a Flammenwerfer over here. Pretty sure, yep. A bit more gold. Okay. So in number 2, this one is like overrun daily, I believe. I've only done number 2 like a couple of times, and I believe once on that. But interrupt the healers when they do that move. Nowhere near those ones over there, but they are gonna start coming over. Okay, there's another healer on board. Take them out. If you want to get anywhere in life, take out the healers. I know that a lot of people are gonna be like, but I'm a healer! Take you out in the PvP. So there's also a strangler here, which we can take out as well. Especially when you want to do, like, say, the speed runs and whatnot, you need to take out every single mob and whatnot. Whee. That was fun. So let's fight. We're now into the animals of Tamriel. And okay, so this one you may just hear me say a lot of "can you fucking not?" Okay. Reason for that is the amount of stunning and all that that this one does. But yeah, so we're all ready, I believe. Mirri is good, my pets are good, and my resources are all up and ready. So let's get this one done, shall we? They will spawn in some stuff that will keep them up. So I will have to do thingy, you know, spriggans, keep them healed. So be sure to defeat those as soon as. The reason why this annoys me is because of the amount of times that you get away and you instantly do have that. Okay, so thing, and that helped me get to this one quicker. Of course, usually it's the tank that deals with this, but I have no tank, there's just me. Okay. As you can see, it's basically the same mechanic over and over. Usually the bosses go for my Clannfear. Do I have to? No. If I wasn't recording, I would like reply to that, but no. Hopefully someone else replies to it, because I've just replied to it in my video, but not everyone in the guild watches my content. Okay, so now there's two. So we take these out. Can we not, maybe? Oh, and look, there's a chest there as well. That's not usually there. Maybe I just never noticed it. Yeah, the reason why I'm recording right now is because on Tuesday, when I do a lot of my recordings, I'm getting my COVID injection. So, like, this week's videos are all being recorded here and now. Okay? So, that's why in a lot of my videos, I'm going to be in the same clothing. Because it's the same day. Today is Sunday the 20th. It's his father's day. The father is not home at the moment, so I'm able to. Thanks, Mirri. You're telling me that the plant is all in my head. Yep. I still haven't worked out as to why it keeps, you know, killing me in. So if, like, say I get to a certain, you know, being away from it a bit, and then it does it, I guess. But to be quite honest, I do not know why it does it. It's just a mechanic, it's an annoying one at that, but it's fine. So we've almost got it down. Mirri hasn't died once yet, which is nice. Okay. I had no stamina just then. Okay. So, just a bit more, and we can open up this chest here, which is right next to the boss. Okay. Oop. Brutal uppick. It's fine. Okay. So, another thing added to my sticker book. Apparently everything else that I've got from this dungeon, I've already got. Okay. Take out the strangler. Two. Alex there. Or however you lot all pronounce it, I do not know. So, take out this one as well. We're about to enter a big room with another side boss. Oh god, stuck in the wall. Okay. So, there's a bunch of adds in here. There is a side boss up there, somewhere. Okay, so first off, we will get these adds done. Okay, so a bunch of them are already running over. So as you can see, just then there was a boss bar that appeared because I got into the area in which the boss is. And there is another thing there. There's actually two bosses in this area. One that I just showed you, and there are some Alex in the other cavern. The cabin behind me, that is. So, over there. You can see there are two Alex. But you can probably only see the one. Right, so we'll take out the strangler, get the chest, that's just here. In number two, this is where a portal will form to take you to a boss fight. But let's not talk about number two. We're on number one. Because this is number one. Okay. So a bit more.
Looks like
there.
You're buying at the next pub, Fla.
Okay, there's the great sword added to my sticker book. We'll take off that. As I said, it's only a short boss. And there he is. There's a healer. That will take them out. Two of them right next to each other. Really not the best idea. Come on. Need to heal up a little bit. Okay, I've only hit the boss a little bit, but I'm more focused on the adds right now. You know, get the adds down. I know which one the boss is. He's coming at me with a club, mace thing. Okay, and meh. He's okay. Okay, now to focus on the boss purely, all of the adds are down. So he's got those little electrical bubbles that shouldn't appear. Try and stay out of them. You can block or dodge with heavy attacks. I prefer to mainly roll dodge. Okay, and there's a strangler here. So this cavern basically loops around. I will show you momentarily once I've killed this thing here. And then kill the boss in this cavern. Dad just ruining my video. Trust Dad to do it. Okay, so there's a baby and there is that. I need to quickly charge up my weapon. I will use the crown soul gem that I got last night with my daily. Okay, so we work on getting rid of the baby one first and then the boss. Okay. Basically he's the same as any old Alfie. Or whatever you want to call them. Okay. With the moves. Just take him out. I do not want to see your butt. I do not like big butts. This one's also using what I use to block, and that is now down. Okay, so we'll see that there's more things in here. Okay, so we'll take those out too. I need to get my magicka back. Mirri, do not do it. Okay, so while I show you the thing as well, I can maybe restore some magicka. Okay, so you can see there's more bad guys here, but this will take you back into this room. Okay, so we'll take out this slot. Okay, healer, healing a healer. That's not unheard of, especially in PvP. Okay, so we'll get rid of the digger, and then we will focus on this guy that's after Mirri. And I shall show you what I mean. Plus, I believe down here there is a strangler, which you need to kill in order to get the speedrun, no death thing. So yeah, so there's the boss that we've just killed. Ooh, and heavy sack. I could have missed that. And I just got some runes from that. So, and this is where the last boss will take place, I believe. So yeah, last boss. So this one will spawn in some skellies. And yeah, so we just gotta wait for it to full on spawn in. Please don't tell me it's bugged. Hello? Ooh, mother.
Stop me.
There's gonna be too much about that now. You jumped. You shat yourself. Ah, I wasn't expecting that, okay? Right, so that circle there with the skellies. That is about to bring in some skeletons, which I then have to jump to. Yeah, basically get rid of the adds as soon as you see them, and then jump straight back onto the boss. Okay. So, another bunch of skellies. We'll do this a few times during this fight. Roll dodge out of that green thing that she throws as well. Do not let that hit you. He is after what would look like to be Mirri. Okay, I did not dodge that, but I didn't know that it was there. So she's summoning in some more skellies. I dodged a little too early there as well. No need. Mirri. No need. Okay, and then there'll be more skellies coming up. Just this very, very often. Ooh, that was a bit of a close call. Oh, they got me. Last 10% we will just burn. Okay.
Roll
thank you, Mirri. I was already planning on that. Someone's wanting some maple. Okay. So. Done. Okay. Oh, and I've got a companion axe too. So, we can show you the dungeons. So we've got Elden Hollow 1.
Akara, look.
So I've got
just as you feel, the ritual
first
complete.
Mask so far.
See how the darkness gathers?
Yes. A couple of
Never
the spark skins.
Even stronger than she.
All of the light speakers. Couple of the undaunted thing here.
What in oblivion was
and
that?
That is it. So guys, I hope that you liked that video. if you did, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos, I guess. Don't forget to check out the Horsemen of Tamriel on Xbox. Yeah. And yeah, stay safe, stay Soul-Shriven, and peace out.